strange fruit hanging from the poplar trees.
Now, well, you had a little bit more than 5 minutes, but I do have a question for you. How well are we doing in recruiting Port Arthur people for jobs there?
Now, cause I ain't got the money on me right now, and I told you to wait. Yeah, I told you to wait. So I'ma need a little more time now, cause I ain't got the money on me right now, and I thought you could wait. Yeah, I thought you could wait. These bitches.
Number 3, proposed resolution number 17725, a resolution supporting the submission of an application by Port Arthur Initiative 1 LP for housing tax credits or private activity bonds at 3501 12th Street, Edison Square, authorizing an allocation of housing tax credits for the approval of the construction of the development, requested by Councilmember Albright. Councilmember Williamson.
Move approval.
Councilmember Freeman.
Second.
It's been moved and second that we approve proposed resolution 17725. Questions? Councilmember Scott.
Yes, thank you, Mayor. I have a list here that was given to me about these tax credits. Port Arthur right now is right at about 4.6 above the state average for tax credits. And I think the city attorney has some information also. Right now we're at two thousand two tax credit units. I have a list here of cities that has pretty much almost the same population that we have, and they're nowhere near the tax credits that Port Arthur are at. Now, city attorney, if we even try to give any more tax credit, that will put us at a percentage of 5% over what the state average is. Is that correct?
Yes, you may.
We would have to calculate the number of units that's being requested, and the memo that I have tells you how to do the calculation. So dependent upon the amount of units that are being added to the 2002, that's how you would determine what the amount per capita would be.
Well, city attorney, I have a sheet here showing already that we are already at 4.6.
We are at 4.6.
Correct. Okay, so that's easily to be calculated. If we offer any more tax credits, we're going to be at 5% over what the state average is. Now, we have someone coming here asking for tax credits, okay? And we just can't afford it. The city can't afford any more tax credits. You have a developer asking for tax credits, okay, already knew what the contract was, already knew what kind of money he was going to make. Now he come back and ask for tax credit, and all that money goes in his pocket. Okay, this is off the taxpayers of this city. This city cannot afford to continue giving tax credits. We have our surrounding cities, Port Neches, Groves, Neyland, they have zero tax credits. Zero. I mean, you have a developer here, like I said, asking for tax credits. He went into a contract knowing what he was going to make, what amount of money he was going to make. He's going to make a profit, but now he comes back to the city and asks us to give him tax credits. The average is already too high. We can't afford to give tax credit to people who's going to make more money when we give them tax credit. We can't give the citizens money away like that. We just can't. So I'm letting the council know that, hey, I have this sheet right here showing what Port Arthur is, the standards of Port Arthur, where we have 2,000 two tax credit units already here in our city. I don't agree with the tax credits because we're taking money from the taxpayers. Those two people who may be involved, the developer and whoever they're developing the property for, okay, if it's housing, they get money in for more money for rent, so they're making money. The developer, they get money for developing the property. So those two people, they're making money. They make their money, but don't come back to the city and ask for tax credits. Those tax credits gonna go right back into the developer pocket. That's more money the developer's making. We cannot afford, when we have citizens here paying taxes, to continue giving tax credits. Thank you.
And my opinion on that is every shoe will not fit every city the same way. We cannot afford to bypass an opportunity to provide decent, affordable housing for the people here in Port Arthur. You may not need one, but at my age, I may need one soon. You know, and if you all are so blessed, maybe you'll reach that age too. But there are too many people who are needing this for us to look at it and scoff at it and laugh at it and talk about the developers. That's not the developers is not the issue. The issue is whether or not we want to provide decent, affordable housing for people who need it. And right now we're talking about senior citizen complex and replacement housing for another complex. I'm not sure what the issue is here. This has nothing to do with the developer. This has something to do with the citizens. And if you can't feel anything for the citizens, I'm just wondering, you know, why you're here. I mean, it just doesn't make a bit of sense to me. So I'm supporting this. I mean, we are given an opportunity. This is going to be a one-time opportunity. I promise you, this one time. This is not coming back around. These are recovery funds, tax credits, but that recovery money will not come back around. Take it from me. This is just a one-time shot that we are being given. And if we bypass it as a council member, then we are not doing our duties to the citizens of Port Arthur who are going to be needing these homes. I'm just going to be honest with you. So now, if anybody doesn't like me for saying it, tough. But and believe me. Okay. All right. All right. She says you can't clap.
Yeah.
It's all right. Just be happy, and pray that it passes, because there are those who don't want it to. So. You've had an opportunity to speak on the issue, however.
We're still up for discussion, Mayor. We're still up for discussion.
Okay. Councilmember Scott.
Okay. Going back, in the beginning, the mayor stated her opinion, and I stated some facts. I am not against housing. That's not what I'm against. Okay? I mean, I heard a lot of clapping. It's fine. I'm not against housing. I didn't speak against housing like the mayor tried to make it seem like I did. I didn't speak against housing. I just said the people that's involved should be accountable. That's all I said. So I don't want any citizen here today to believe that I'm against housing. That's not what I said, okay? I just said that the two parties who want tax credits should be held accountable, and that I not only represent all citizens, those that pay tax, don't pay taxes. That's not what this is about. This is about, we have enough tax credits already in our city, and we cannot afford to give more tax credits. So I don't want any citizen here to believe what such thing that was said by the mayor that I'm against housing. First of all, I'd like to say to all the citizens that are here tonight, when I ran for city council, I ran saying that I would make sure that I'd be a link that connect the people to city government and city government to the people. And that's basically what I'm doing. And in order to do that, I have to be able to bring information to the citizens to let them know what's going on here, and bring their information to city government to let them know what the citizens think. And in order for me to be a council member, I must be the voice of the people. No one is talking about, we were talking about the property at Edison. No one is talking about the property at Edison. It's in my district. Okay. And if any citizen in my district, or even in Port Arthur, state that they don't want something in their neighborhood, I am the people voice, so I speak for the people. No one has told you that the citizens in this particular area, Edison, oppose this. Oppose it to the point where to rezone this area, it would take 20% of the citizens in that particular area to get a supermajority vote. 20%. We have 26%. 26% of the citizens in that particular area oppose this. Now, you being a citizen, just think if somebody want to put something in your neighborhood. I'm your representative, your councilman. You tell me, Councilman Scott, I'm not against housing. I just don't want it in my that facility in my neighborhood. Then if I'm representing you, I have to speak the voice of the people. This is all this is about, me speaking the voice of the people. The people don't want it there. And if they don't want it there, I'm a council member. I should stand for the citizens and not allow any entity to come push something in the citizen neighborhood. When this project came to me, I said to Mr. Eichbeer, I said to him, I don't have a say-so in this. I told him to get with the citizens in that particular area. He said, okay. And I told him, if the citizen says no, I'm their voice, I say no. If the citizen says yes, I say yes. So this is not about me going against housing. This is about the citizens in that particular area has spoken. And yes, housing can go somewhere else. I'm for that. I'm not against housing at all. But I am a voice for the people. And the other, everybody up here, this is what this position stands for. You being a voice for the people. Not just for some people, but for all people. And when those citizens have come to the conclusion to work hardly to walk their neighborhood and get a 26.5% of those people in that area don't want it in that area. They didn't say they don't want housing. They said they just don't want it in that particular area. I'm not saying I don't want housing. I'm saying that the citizens have spoken. They don't want it in that particular area. That's it. And that's what I would do for any citizen here in Port Arthur. I am the voice of the people, and the people have spoken.
Councilmember.